Stadium, this legendary venue. Nguyen ranked number 4 and Casotti looking to take him down here tonight.
Yeah, pay close attention to those calf kicks thrown by Martin Nguyen. He takes out the lower part of your leg like none other in the featherweight division. As Casotti says, Mitch, I'll change your mind on that. I got calf kicks too.
Yeah, you can see Casotti with that backward motion like he's coiling on that back leg, just looking to draw Nguyen in and unload that right hand.
Casotti's got that wide stance, similar to Tan Lee, gave the Martin Nguyen a lot of problems in their title matchup. Big, wide hook thrown by Casotti. Let's see if Casotti can find some of those same kind of angles and those movements that the elusive Tan Lee did. Trying to pull Martin Nguyen in some of these big punches. As Casotti continues to try to chop down the legs of Martin Nguyen.
Casotti was smart to go back to the kick right there because he was swinging big and Martin was starting to read the timing of those hands.
Martin Nguyen cutting the angles off well, trying to trap Casotti in that corner. Big power out of that right hand thrown by Martin Nguyen. Like to see him start setting things up though with that jab. Nguyen's got a beautiful jab. Let's see if he starts to utilize it.
How about the mindset, Rich, of Casotti? It feels like you can go into this scene, you got nothing to lose playing with house money. Is it accurate?
I always hate the phrase nothing to lose because you have a fight to lose and it's a big deal. But for him, this is an opportunity. We talked to him about that this week and he said, man, when something like this comes your way, former two division champ, like you don't pass an opportunity like this up.
But the thing is you can lose your consciousness fighting Martin Nguyen. He will put you to sleep and you will be waking up looking at those pretty little ring lights with one momentary lapse of concentration. So you can lose a lot here. And this is a huge opportunity for Casotti to really go in there against a top level featherweight contender and make his statement by announcing himself to the world.
Let's be clear, maybe Nguyen has lost 3 of his last 4, but he's still only 33 years of age. Definitely feels like he can get back to the top and get a world title in this division once again.
Yeah, I'm a little shocked though that Nguyen here isn't putting some things in Casotti's face. The jab, particularly as Mitch was talking about earlier, giving him something to talk about because he's just allowing Casotti to move forward.
To sleep, turning Casotti into a grapple.
Huge knee from Nguyen on the way up.
Yeah, that was a desperation shot for sure. Casotti now realizes he's in a real fight.
Casotti tried for the takedown after taking a huge overhand right. And then when he didn't get it on their way up, a big knee there from Nguyen.
You can see Casotti's stance starting to get really static here. He's moving less and less. And Nguyen's just going to use that micro movement and going to the body. He's going to come back upstairs with this headshot. It's coming.
Martin punishing the legs early on, trying to chop down the legs of Casotti, getting him stationary. Casotti goes with the low kick.
Nguyen tenderizing that front leg, to your point, as Casotti delivers a left to the belly.
Very patient is the situation. As he takes out the leg, chopping down the limbs, and that support is not there on that left leg of Casotti.
Ripping at the body of Nguyen.
Casotti is a very elusive, footwork-influenced fighter. He loves to pull people in with the drawing of the head movement and the evasion, but right now he's not able to do that because that left leg is severely damaged. It looks like it's not severely damaged, but it's becoming compromised.
Yeah, it looks like he doesn't have the same spring on. He's really flat-footed on the front leg. That's limiting his movement. He lands one there.
You can see the swelling that's starting to develop on that lower left leg of Casotti, as he still got power in those hands, though.
Casotti with the blue gloves. It's Nguyen ranked number 4 in the red gloves. Nguyen representing Vietnam and Australia. Casotti representing Brazil. Again, chopping away at the front leg is Nguyen. Casotti with a nice combination on the counterattack. Big left, Nguyen. 20 seconds, round 1.
Man, man, when Nguyen lands, he's landing with bad intentions.
Peppering the jab there, Casotti. 10 seconds to go in the first. Head kick, Casotti.
Casotti's wearing the damage well.
Yeah,
little
toddler,
he does, adorable.
He's adorable, but he looks like he's got a little muscle for his age as well.
I know you called it a desperation shot, Rich, but I like the change of just giving Martin Nguyen something else to think about with the takedown attempt. I know he might not have been successful, but at least Nguyen is now thinking that a takedown could be coming from the Brazilian kickboxing champion.
Early stages, round number two. Nguyen ranked number four in the featherweight division against Casotti.
Not a lot of heat behind those calf kicks, but they are touching up Casotti. And that's just going to pay dividends as this match goes on.
Nice jab there from Casotti. Measuring the distance here on Nguyen.
Still not sure why Nguyen's corner didn't tell him to get his jab or something active just to put something in Casati's face. Like you said, Casotti can give him something to think about, so too does Nguyen.
Nguyen just gave him something to think about by putting something in his face, and that was that right hand, Rich.
I just feel like he'd get it done quicker if he was throwing that left jab out there a few times.
Oh, 100%, but Nguyen don't need no jabs. When you got power in that right hand like that, flying knees like Nguyen can put on you, and that lead, that low leg kick is working like a jab. It's setting up that right hand. It's getting Casotti thinking about downstairs, and then Nguyen will come up top. Woo!
Nguyen at the body there, Casotti.
Nguyen threw two of those shovel hooks right there, and that was giving Casotti something to think about.
Casotti willing to stand in a trade, though. I'm impressed by this young man so far.
Nguyen's going with the jabs, but they're to the body of Casotti. That's like the third or fourth jab, fifth jab that he's thrown to the body of Casotti.
Jab the face that time of Casotti, and another one, snapping the head back of Leonardo Casotti.
One thing that we should note here is off of all of Nguyen's combinations right there, good head slip there. When he threw that right to the body and just threw that overhand right there, like he's getting his head offline. He's not there really to be hit by Casotti on the counter.
Yeah, Casotti's gonna have to make some adjustments with those counter punches because Martin Nguyen is dipping his head so far off to the side. If Casotti starts throwing high roundhouse kicks, he might be able to connect off those slips that Nguyen's doing.
Hook to the body from Nguyen, then the calf kick and a couple of more.
Yeah, you can see the welt starting to develop on that lead leg of Casotti from those low leg kicks.
Nice left from Casotti on the way in.
Casotti needs to do a better job cutting off this ring.
So he wasn't bothered by this last minute opponent change. Martin Nguyen has been preparing for several different opponents over the course of his training camp, or at least this week, right, Rich? So both these guys experienced some adversity as Martin Nguyen lands a nice little right hand.
And he quarter turned out right there and just came back with that hook.
But coming out of the stoppage, you like Casotti there, the spinning back fist and then the head kick. And going up top with a kick again.
He's starting to mix things up now, and that this is the kind of strategy he needs to get Nguyen thinking, at least.
Stiff jab from Nguyen, 144 in round two.
Piece pops out, Casotti's on the retreat. Martin Nguyen hunting.
Nguyen, the overhand right. Right, he's cut off the angle, he's got his man in the corner. Now coming out of the corner is Casotti.
Herbie's waiting for an opportunity to stop this action and pop that mouthpiece back in. Casotti gets protected.
Casotti pretty pleased with what he's shown so far with 80 seconds to go in the second.
You know, this is, you know, the top shelf of the featherweight division he's in there against, and he has proven that he belongs with the upper echelon of this division. Showcasing toughness, weathered some adversity, got clipped a couple of times and is still in there.
And got clipped a couple of times against Martin Nguyen. Like, that's not just any fighter that's standing in front of him.
Yeah, Martin Nguyen has a highlight reel of right hand KOs that every fighter dreams about having, myself included. And that flying knee knockout against Jadamba was a thing of beauty. So this guy is a highlight reel KO artist. And Casotti's in there getting it done against one of the best. Spinning back fist, Martin Nguyen says that was good.
Yeah, that's two of them now in this round from Casotti.
Casotti's made some adjustments here with his head work. He's slipped a few punches and it made Martin miss. I like what he's doing in the last minute.
Trade 15 seconds. Entertaining stuff, trading hooks now.
Nice little touch for Casotti on Nguyen's chin.
Snap Nguyen's head back that time with 5 seconds in the second. Nguyen, and that's it.
Seeing his athlete shoot some double legs, which Martin Nguyen has a good takedown.
Yeah, I think Martin's a much more complete fighter than he showed in this particular match tonight. Typically does a really good job with the jab. Like you said this earlier, Mitch, he's got a beautiful jab. Throws that shovel hook to the lead body. We haven't seen a ton of that tonight. And, you know, obviously the leg kicks has done a great job. You're looking at Casotti's calf. But we haven't seen one takedown attempt by Martin. Great slip kick from him, but he's so many more tools that he just hasn't shown in this particular match.
Yeah, this fight, he really wants to show off that low leg kick and that big right hand. I wonder if he's surprised that Casotti's still in there. He seems to be having a problem with his face. He keeps wiping his eyes.
4 minutes to go in the fight. Fourth-ranked Nguyen against Casotti. Casotti's with a back kick. Cut the head that time of Nguyen.
Look at a little couple arrow there.
Casotti's showing some tricks in his bag as Martin Nguyen continues to beat on that leg. I am surprised that Casotti is still moving forward the way that he is, because Martin Nguyen has touched that in the double digits.
Casotti's moving forward right now, but he probably will not be tomorrow.
Good thing it's a short plane ride back to Phuket for him.
3:20 to go. Casotti standing in, trying to cut off the angles here.
Rich, give us an unofficial scorecard. How do you have this one going down so far?
Man, you're calling me out in the middle of the round. I'll tell you what, give me a second to think about this one.
Well, hold your feet to the fire. What do you think, Mitch?
I think he has shown a little bit more superior striking. He's showing the aggressive. He's showing the aggression. He's walking down Casotti, engaging in the fight, forcing the action. And he's also landed some significant shots, especially to that lower leg. It might not be the biggest, most impactful shots, but they are scoring. And that seems to be giving, at least in my eyes, him the advantage.
Spin back fist there, Casotti.
Well, keep in mind that those leg kicks, I mean, you can see the actual damage, which is one of our scoring categories. But also note, like, in that first round, Nguyen wobbled Casotti, which is what caused Casotti to take that shot, which is an internal damage as well. So both those things are going to score on the scorecard, which is our second highest scoring category.
I know Rich don't like to be wrong, and he's been wrong so many times tonight, Brent, that he's afraid to put himself out there. Me, on the other hand, no, I'll make the call. I'll go against the great, and there's that takedown that Amran Sung was asking for. And that's a huge scoring opportunity right there for Martin Nguyen.
With 2 minutes to go in the fight, he gets Casotti to the canvas.
Beautiful job by Martin Nguyen to end up in the half guard of Casotti. Let's see if Martin Nguyen can get past this half guard. He's got the pressure down with his right leg on the leg of Casotti as he tries to slide his knee out. Casotti's doing a good job of maintaining the guard so far, but Nguyen is aggressively trying to pass. He's trying to get that knee clear of the leg. This is a good spot as he's driving the shoulder right into the chin of Leonardo Casotti.
Yeah, you can see that Nguyen right there was starting to look for the Kimura and then use that to regain the underhook on that side of the body there.
75 seconds remaining, third and final round. Again, the bout judged as a whole here in one championship.
Nguyen's trying to get that leg out of the half guard. You can see Casotti's trying to utilize a lockdown just to trap that leg in position, but Nguyen now pushing on the leg to try to clear his leg. Now the knee's past the leg. Let's see if he can get that foot out. Might choose to go to the other side, but might just sit here and do work for the last 40 seconds.
A couple of short lefts there from Nguyen in tight quarters on the canvas, 35 seconds remaining.
This is a big win for Martin Nguyen if he's able to get in here today. He's had a lot of tough times, and you know, as Rich was talking about on the walk, he's went through a lot to get to this point and to get a big win.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure this takedown and maintaining this dominant position here has sealed the victory for him at this point in time. You talked about the damage he was on the calf earlier. We talked about